Today on Bits, we're going to talk about the speed square. The speed square is a great and really inexpensive tool that you should definitely have in your toolkit. A lot of the features are geared towards people who are building homes. They have a lot to do with the rise and run of rafters, and we'll get to that in a minute. But there's also several features that you can use in everyday woodworking projects. One of the most common uses is to draw a perpendicular line to your workpiece. The speed square has a foot that you can lock against any edge and then automatically have a 90 degree angle that you can draw a line or cut against. But you can also use the pivot point on the corner to draw a line at any angle from 0 to 90 degrees. You can also use this as a way to cut a 90 degree angle to your workpiece. You line up the foot on the edge of your piece and then run the base of your saw along the other edge. You can also use this tool to square up your saws. You can set the foot on the table of your table saw and then align the blade rotation to make sure that it matches up with the perpendicular line. You can do the same thing on a bandsaw to make sure that the table is square to the blade. And in fact, you can do the same thing on a circular or a jigsaw. But like I said before, this is most often used when building a home. It's easy to find the pitch of a roof by using the speed square. Line up the pivot point or corner of your speed square on the angle of the roof and then put a torpedo level across the top. Once you get that top line level, you'll clearly see what the angle of the roof is on the speed square. And when you look at the tool, you'll see a lot of different lines with several different indications. Along the bottom, there's 0 to 90 degrees, and these are pretty obvious. The common indicates the rise in inches over a 12-inch run for common rafters. The hip val indicates the rise over a 17-inch run for hip or valley rafters. And of course, usually one edge of these speed squares has a ruler on it, so that's handy as well. They come in lots of different sizes, from 6-inch up to 12 and 18-inch. They're metal, they're plastic, there are lots of different variations, and usually they are pretty inexpensive to pick up. There's probably lots of other uses for a speed square, and if you know some that I didn't mention, please put them down in the comments so that everybody can learn together. Big thanks to Brightwood College for sponsoring this video, and if you want to find out more about them, click the link right there. I've also got a playlist of other Bits videos, and I'll be back later this week with a new project. I'll see you then.